Hello friends, in this video I will show you how to rotate and crop an image in Android. So here I have created this project, and in this project I have this croputils.java. It contains many different classes which can be used to crop an image, and it contains this class CropImageView which can be used as an image view. It extends AppCompatImageView, and the code in it can be used describes an image view which can be used to crop an image. So let's start with our project. Here in activity main.xml I have four buttons at the top. First one is button 1, this is for picking image. Then I have this button 2 for rotating the image. Then I have this crop button which will take me to crop activity. And then I have this share button, button 4, which is empty at present. I will show you the share function in next video. Then I have this image view 1, which is for displaying the image, and scale type here is fit center. So now let's go to main activity.java. Here at the top I have declared image view 1, and in onCreate I have defined image view 1 using its ID. And I have defined all the four buttons, button 1, 2, 3, 4 using their IDs in onCreate. And then I have onClick listener for all the four buttons, button 1, button 2, button 3 and button 4. All this is in onCreate. Here the onCreate ends. And after this I have a method called ActivityResultLauncher called mGetContent. This method will be used to pick the file, pick the image file. And it contains this method on activity result. And here we will get the URI of the picked file or picked image. So we can use this URI to do our job. So this method mGetContent is used when button one is clicked. Button one is the pick file button. So here I use this method mGetContent.launch image slash star. So this will pick any image. This is the type of file which it can pick, and when the file is picked we get the URI of the file. And here I've set the string variable image underscore URI to URI.toString. Here at the top you can see that I have defined this string variable image underscore URI is equal to empty string, empty. And when the image is picked, it is set to URI.toString. Then I have this try catch exception code, and inside this I get the bitmap from URI. Inside I convert this URI to bitmap image, and that is show bitmap. And then I save this bitmap to cache, the app cache, and that will be show bitmap. And then I display this show bitmap in image view 1. Now I will show you these methods: get bitmap from URI and save bitmap to cache. So these methods I have defined here outside onCreate. So here I have this method private bitmap, get bitmap from URI, throws IO exception. So here it takes this URI and converts it to bitmap, which is returned. And this is the code which it uses. You can just copy it from link in description. So basically it converts the URI of to a bitmap image. And then I have this method save bitmap to cache. So here it takes this bitmap and save it to cache. Where does it save it? It saves it to get cache directory with the file name final underscore image.jpg. So the bitmap image is saved in cache directory with name final underscore image.jpg. Okay, and then I have these two more methods, get bitmap from cache and rotate bitmap. So this method get bitmap from cache will get the file final underscore image.jpg from cache directory and convert it to bitmap, which is returned as bitmap here. So once the image is picked, it will be displayed in image view 1 and it will be saved in cache. And then the user will click on the crop button, which is button 3. So when this button 3 is clicked, I will use intent to move to crop activity. Okay, and let's move to crop activity. For this, I have crop.xml and it contains this crop image view and button. So this crop image view is a view with class com.example.mathfragments. This is the package name of my app, and then dot crop utils, which is this Java file, dollar crop image view. This is a class or a subclass in crop utils. So this crop utils has ID crop, sorry, this crop image view has ID crop image view. And then there is this button which has ID done underscore button. Now in crop activity, I have defined this done underscore button as button one, and I've defined this crop image view as image view one, which I have declared here at top. Crop utils dot crop image view one. So initially, I get the bitmap from cache and display it in image view one. So here I have the same method which I had in main activity. These two methods are also there in main activity. So this one is save bitmap to cache. This saves, this takes the bitmap image and saves it to cache directory with file name find underscore image.jpg, which is the same file name as in main activity. So this complete method is same as in main activity, and this one is also same. Here I get the image from find underscore image.jpg, convert it to bitmap, and that bitmap is returned here. So the image in find underscore image.jpg, I convert it to bitmap and display it in image view 1. After this, I have on click listener for button 1. Button 1 is the done button. So when the cropping is done, so when this is clicked, I get the cropped image from image view 1, which is actually a crop image view. So I get the cropped image from crop image view, and that will be bitmap. And then I save this bitmap to cache in this try catch exception code, and then I finish this activity. Okay, so I get the cropped image and save it to cache by using this code with name find underscore image.jpg, and then I finish this activity. So when I finish this activity, I will go back to main activity, and here in main activity, it will automatically execute on start code. So here in on start, I check if this string variable image underscore URI is not empty. Okay, when we pick an image, it is set to URI.toString. Initially it is empty, and when we pick an image, it will set to URI.toString. So if it is not empty, we get the bitmap from cache, which means we get the image from cache and convert it to bitmap, and then we display it in image view 1 using this code. Okay, this is in onStart method. Now it has one more button, which is button 2. This is for rotating the image. Here I get the bitmap from cache, and that bitmap will be show bitmap. Then I rotate this show bitmap, and the result will be rotated image. Now I will show you this method, rotate bitmap. So in rotate bitmap, I use matrix and rotate this matrix, and then on this rotated matrix, I create another bitmap using the dimensions of previous bitmap, and that will be my result, means rotated bitmap, which is bitmap 2 here. So I use this method when button 2 is clicked to get the rotated image, and then I save this rotated image to cache at the same file path which I have shown you. Save bitmap to cache, it saves the image to find underscore image.jpg in cache directory. Okay, and once this is saved, I get the bitmap from cache and display it in image view 1, and this also has this IO exception. Okay, and I had a share button which is empty now. This I will show you in next video. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this. Okay, now I have to show you the app. So this is the app. When I pick an image, here I can pick an image. So let us pick this peacock. Okay, and now I will rotate this image. Okay, and now I will crop this image. So I can crop it to get only the head of this peacock horizontally. Okay, this much done. So here is the cropped image. So that's all in this video. Thank you very much for watching this.